Welcome back. So in the previous step, we saw and set up the currency exchange service. Our main goal, you know, is to pass the from and the to currency. Okay, from which currency and the to currency you want the exchange rate. Okay, and that should get from the database. Okay, so currently we have set up the currency exchange service, microservices. Okay, so first we will see how can we fetch the details from the database. So we have seen like the currency service will be our web service, and we'll be passing the currency from currency and the to currency, and this service should return the exchange rate. How will the exchange rate from 1 USD to INR? Okay. So, you know, we have seen that while setting up the currency exchange service, we have given the default port 8001, correct? So currently we have just set up this. Let's do some hard coding to return the currency exchange rate, and thereafter we will remove the hard code and we'll try to retrieve all the information from the database, like what is the from currency, what is the to currency, what is the exchange rate of that, and on which port basically the currency exchange service are running. Okay, so we had just set up this currency exchange service and we had just given the application name and the server port. So let's go ahead and create the controller, create a service. Okay, so go to the SageMoon Java, control N. Okay, go to class. Okay, and currency exchange or give the package name as a controller. Okay, and give the controller name currency exchange controller. Okay, oops, currency exchange controller. Okay, finish. Okay, this is the controller. So how you need to make it controller? Annotation rest controller. Okay, so basically what is the annotation rest controller? Okay, so it's a nothing but the shortcut to use both annotation controller and the response body. If you go to the Spring 4 version, only if you are using the Spring, then you will have to use both annotation controller and annotation response body to make the class as a controller together. Okay, so you know, this is basically used to development the RESTful web services. Okay, so you know, the controller and the response body is, REST controller is a mix up of the @ controller or @ response body, right? So this is the way you are making a response as a JSON response. So this will help you to make the REST API. Okay, so let's go there and create one method, public. Okay, and let's create one bing for now. Currency exchange, let's say rate. Okay, and get currency exchange rate. Okay, this will be a controller. So this is the method, and this method need to map with some HTTP method, right? So what is the HTTP method that we are going to use? We are going to annotation get mapping, right? Get mapping, and we need to pass here the path of the controller that we are getting. Okay, so this basically annotation get mapping is the HTTP get request, and that is going to handle the HTTP get request. Okay, so you know, it acts as a shortcut for request mapping method. Earlier this was the method. but in a Spring Boot, in using the REST API, you can use the annotation get mapping, okay, to handle the method. Okay, so this request get mapping HTTP method will mapped with this method, right? So how the request is going to come like this. Okay, so if you go here, just copy the request from here to here, right? From service, correct? So currency service, yeah, so this is the service name, then from and to. So from and to are coming, so we will have to accept two parameter, string from comma string to, right? And if you are saving the basically the attribute from the client, okay, then we'll have to map this, right? USD, correct? So map this, this is coming as a from, this value will coming as a from, and INR is also coming from client too, correct? And this will have to map, this value should be mapped with this from. So how you can do this? Using the annotation path variable, right? Path variable, that's it. And this also annotation path variable, right? Correct. And this entity we have not created it, so let's create this. Okay, control 1, create class currency exchange rate. Okay, and put this in a entity bin, because later we are going to use with JPA. Okay, so let's create this. So let's create private, let's create first one ID, then private string from private string to, okay, private big decimal, let's take this big decimal, and this will be the rate, exchange rate, right? Exchange rate, correct. And take also one more variable, or leave it for, we'll add later. Right. Now create the constructor for this. Go to constructor using field, select all, generate. Okay, create a default constructor. This will help to make JPA happy. We'll see in the later step how you are going to use this, and make this as a protected. Okay, now put getter and setter here. Source, generate getter and setter, select all, generate. Okay, done, save it. Okay, now come here, and we have just created an entity bin. Just return new currency exchange rate, right? What was our first parameter? It was ID. So let's give the ID 1001, comma, from was USD, right? And 2 was INR, just putting the hard code, huh? And let's say exchange rate from USD to INR is 73, right? Just 73 is a big decimal, so you'll have to big decimal dot value of, okay, done. Okay, so now see, our controller is ready, REST controller. This will help to make a REST API and make this class as a controller. Okay, and the HTTP get method basically is going to handle that request, and this is going to map with this method. Okay, so now let's run this currency exchange application. Let it run. Yeah, it's running. So we are running on the port 8001, right? So let it run. Yeah, you see here Tomcat is started on port 8001. Okay, so the application is running. Now go there. Okay, earlier it was not available, so the site cannot be reached, something refused message was coming. Now enter this. Okay, see, we are passing the hard code 1001 from currency is USD to currency is INR. Okay, and the exchange is returning the 73. This is what we put in here, right? Correct. So now let's see, to make it more meaningful, let's put here in case of from, yeah, let it be. Okay, let it be, we'll see later on. Okay, I wanted to put the from currency, but then it's fine, it's okay. Okay, so you can see here at the hard coded value, these things are coming. So now we want to enhance one more thing. You want to just put on which basically the port basically this particular instance is running, right? So currency exchange service microservices can run on the multiple instance, right? That we have seen here. Okay, so it will run on the multiple instance. So just I have mentioned currently it's running on 8001. It can, we can create on another instance, and that port will be running on 8002. Okay, so at each time currently, you know, we cannot run since we are putting this port hard coded here, and we are asking to run on the 8001. Okay, but for now our currency exchange service are working fine with the hard coded. Okay, in the next step we'll see how can we dynamically set the port, because you are going to run on the multiple port, right? So we will be running different instances on the currency exchange server that will be running on the different port. Okay, so thanks for watching. See you in the next step. Bye bye.